St Pauli is probably the most famous second division team in Europe. It's famous due to its supporters who are incredibly passionate and political to the point of having a huge impact on the history of the club. Almost every football fan in Europe associates a Jolly Roger with his team from Hamburg. But not as many people can name the players who've made the club's recent history. Founded in 1910, shortly after the defeat of fascism, St Pauli emerged as one of the best football teams in Germany. Between 1948 and 1951, the club were fighting for the title every season. The Bundesliga was founded in 1962, but for St Pauli, the 60s and 70s were a couple of poor decades. After the club reached the Bundesliga for the first time in 1977, more and more left-wing fans were joining the stands of the Millerntor. The club reached the Bundesliga again in 1988, and during the 1990s, it consolidated its reputation as an elevator club, running up and down between first and second division. In the summer of the year 2000, only a last-minute goal in the last game of the season helped St Pauli avoid relegation.
Ich bereite mich jetzt schon auf Bayern München vor.
Glatt gelungen.
Auf Effe, meinen alten Kollegen. Und ich sag den Rothosen, zieht euch warm an.
In 2002, FC St Pauli wrote one of the most beautiful pages in its history, defeating the world champions of Bayern Munich in the Millerntor in a thrilling game that St Pauli fans still remember fondly today.
Bayern Munich just won the world championship, so they were a big team with players like Scholl, Olli Kahn in the goal, all the national players. Effenberg was captain at the time. And yeah, we were just a team of no names.
Der FC Bayern München, klar, als Meister angereist ans Millerntor mit einer großen Erwartungshaltung. Wir, Underdog, haben gerade weil es ja auch in dieser Saison nicht so prickelnd lief, auch nicht erwartet, dass wir den großen Meister weghauen.
Nobody expected St. Pauli to win.
Wir waren wieder abgeschlagen Letzter. So ging es David gegen Goliath im Prinzip.
At the Millerntor, something unimaginable happened. The brown and white scored twice in the opening half an hour and managed to cruise safely to the 90th minute when the guests scored one.
Etwas passiert, was wir für niemals für möglich gehalten haben, dass wir den großen FC Bayern München besiegt haben. Das war schon eine Hausnummer, muss ich ganz ehrlich sagen. Sowas vergisst man nicht.
In the end, this moment, when the referee whistled the final second of the game, it's definitely in my personal top 5 of the loudest moments at the Millerntor.
Und das war das einer der schönsten Gefühle, die man haben kann, weil du spielst nicht gegen irgendjemanden, sondern gegen den Champions League Meister.
While drinking in that night of the 6th February 2002, somebody came to the idea to make a T-shirt out of this match, you know, because Bayern Munich was the world champion.
Und ja, und dann war es ja auch klar, dass dann irgendwie gleich eine Idee geboren war, dass du dann den Weltpokalsieger-Besieger warst.
Unfortunately for St Pauli, that was one of only 4 games won that entire season. 3 points were never earned away from the Millerntor, and in May the club was relegated to the second Bundesliga.
There were different opinions on how this season would go.
Auf jeden Fall haben wir die ersten Spiele definitiv richtig gut abgekackt. Das waren wieder ein Auswärtsspiel in Frankfurt, muss es gewesen sein, das 4-0. Dann das Zuhause gegen Aalen, noch eine Klatsche gekriegt. Auch glaube ich 1-4 oder was. So, und das fand ich schon sehr, sehr beschissen.
I especially remember a match against Lübeck, where we lost 0-6. We got 6 goals. It was one goal after another. St. Pauli didn't really have a chance to score a goal. So it was a really sad game. Maybe that was the first time when people thought of, shit, maybe we are going down to third league this year.
And a few months after the historic victory against the world champions, St Pauli were catapulted into the third division. This relegation could be considered one of the worst on-pitch moments in the club's history. But outside the stadium, there was another battle to fight, the looming shadows of bankruptcy.
In the summer 2003, when we got relegated to third division, in the first place, it wasn't sure if we would even get the license to play in the third division because the club was so deep in debt.
The entire St. Pauli fan base came together to organise the Rita campaign and collect money to save the club. Thanks to these efforts, bankruptcy was avoided, although St. Pauli were still left in the third division.
Dadurch, dass da wirklich jetzt die zweite Mannschaften der großen Vereine ja im Prinzip mitgekickt haben, hat man gedacht, Mensch, das wird ein eventuell ein leichterer Spaziergang als in der ersten oder zweiten Bundesliga. Aber das war es definitiv nicht. Daraufhin gab es natürlich die größte Demütigung meines Erachtens nach, dass wir gegen die Rauten, die zweite Mannschaft der Rauten, leider noch mit 1-0 verloren haben.
So maybe that was the lowest point for also the fan base, for the supporters, because everybody had a colleague in at work or someone in school who went watching the UE Cup games of HSV first team, and yeah, we were playing in third league against their second team and even lost two of those matches.
Das war schon eine Katastrophe.
A spark of hope was shown in 2005 and 2006 when it reached the semi-finals of the DFB Pokal. The following season, the team managed to achieve promotion to the second division. But the first step to escaping from hell didn't start in the easiest way.
The first half of the season was going like the 3 years before. We were like in the middle of the table.
So hat man sich von Andreas Bergmann getrennt und das Zepter übernahm Stanislavski. Holger Stanislavski, ein ehemaliger super Abwehrstratege, der Kopf und Kragen immer hingehalten hat und alles dafür gegeben hat, dass der Verein wirklich dort ist, wo er jetzt ist ungefähr. Ich glaube, wir waren 12. der Hinrunde und sind Ende der Saison doch aufgestiegen und haben alles weggehauen. Der Kiez bebte, Reeperbahn war komplett dicht, mit 100.000 St. Paulianerinnen und St. Paulianer. Es war ein sensationeller Tag, endlich 2007. Der Aufstieg war endlich mal in der zweiten Bundesliga wieder angekommen. Ja, dann verlief das die ersten 2 Jahre ganz entspannt. Wir haben uns immer wieder versucht, nach oben zu katapultieren.
The decision twist took place in St. Pauli's first season in the second division.
The years before, the success of the team was more coming from fighting and not really having high-class technical football. But in that season, you kind of got the impression that in St. Pauli, football can also play it on a technical way, not only on this fight way.
Und dieses technisch visierte mit dem Kampfgeist und in den Rücken, hinter den Spielern, die Fans im Rücken, haben es dazu beigetragen, dass wir endlich im Oberhaus angeklopft haben. Und das war sehr, sehr wichtig, auch dementsprechend für uns auch mal etwas Gutes in diesem Jahrzehnt, nachdem man so einen Abgang von der ersten bis in die dritte Liga gemacht hat, in die Regionalliga, dass man endlich von der Regionalliga hoch in die zweite und jetzt endlich an der ersten Liga angeklopft hat.
Maybe the most special thing about this promotion to the first league was that it happened in our 100th birthday. So St. Pauli was celebrating 100 years of club existing, and at the same time we got promoted to the first league. So there were two occasions to celebrate, and we like occasions to celebrate.
Going back to the Bundesliga also meant the return of the derby with HSV. The home game was a draw, while the second was an amazing 0-1 win at HSV's arena. This one was the first derby win for the Brown and Whites in 34 years, and the only one that many St. Pauli supporters had seen in their lifetimes.
Als wir dann beim HSV dann angetreten sind, war die Erwartungshaltung auch nicht so groß. Schön eine Ecke, Verlängerung, Ball, Asamoah köpft das noch rein gegen Rost auf unserer Seite. das 1-0.
The away sector was maybe the only part of the stadium making noise. The rest of the stadium was totally silent.
Pliquet hat zu dem Zeitpunkt nicht im Tor gestanden. Da war Matthias Hein im Tor. Und er hatte aber ein Versprechen von Stani bekommen, dass er für das Spiel sich bereit machen sollte.
He put the second keeper in the goal because he knew that Benedict Pliquet, our keeper in that days, would be really motivated playing the other Hamburg club because he played for HSV in the youth teams, and later he got kicked out there and he wasn't really happy with that. He played and he had some great savings. In the end, when we were celebrating in the stadium, there's this really famous picture of him kicking the corner flag.
Nachdem es abgepfiffen wurde und es stand dann fest, dass wir Derbysieger waren. Es war einer der schönsten Gefühle überhaupt. Das war zu vergleichen mit einem Bayern-Sieg damals 2-1.
Alongside Piquet, Holger Stanislavski was a symbol of this 10-year cycle at St. Pauli. He was on the pitch when David defeated Goliath in 2002 and was loyal to the brown and white shirt in the hell of the third division during troubled times and the brink of bankruptcy. From the bench, he guided his beloved club to win an amazing derby against the other half of the city.
Then he was the vice president, he was the manager of the team, and he was also the coach of the team. He had some special activities and tasks to do in the club. That's why he is so much connected to the club and everybody still loves him.
Hut ab vor ihm. Er hat uns wirklich aus der Regionalliga in die erste Liga geführt, hat uns auch sehr gut dort weitergebracht und hat uns unter anderem, was man definitiv ihn immer anerkennen muss, das glückliche Händchen mit Pliquet gehabt, der alles gehalten hat, zu Null gespielt hat und wir Derby-Sieger wurden. Und das kann uns niemand wegnehmen.
After that season in the Bundesliga, he left St. Pauli to become the first manager of Hoffenheim and then Cologne.
And after that, he started running a supermarket here in Hamburg. So that's maybe a special thing of a professional football biography. Not being employed in the football business anymore, but running a supermarket.
There are many reasons to fall in love with a football club. It could be because it's the club of your city or the message it delivers. St. Pauli doesn't make any exception. The reasons to support the brown and white are many, but to understand this passion, one must also know the ups and downs of this remarkable club.